Hi, welcome to the .NET Monthly Roundup for November 2022. I'm John Galloway, and I'll bring you all the highlights in 3 minutes or less. All right, first off, .NET Conf. It was at the beginning of the month. All the videos are posted, over 80 of them for you to watch and enjoy. We also ran a student zone, so you can watch the video for that, download the sample code, and go through that. .NET 7 was released. So much cool stuff here. First of all, MAUI was released. One of the big focuses in MAUI was in performance, and so there's a whole blog post running through those updates there. ASP.NET Core included a bunch of features for servers and runtime, minimal APIs, tons of other stuff. There's also a performance rundown for ASP.NET Core 7 performance improvements there too. EF7 came out with JSON column mappings, bulk updates, TPC, and tons of other great stuff. WPF in .NET 7 added accessibility improvements, focus on performance, and lots more. And there are updates for Windows Forms, including accessibility features, high DPI, and UI automation. Orleans had some huge performance improvements too, and C# 11 picked up string literals, generic math required members, and much more. F# 7 added static abstract members, support in interfaces, required property checking, AOT improvements, and lots of other great stuff. And ML 2.0 added text classification scenario and model builder, sentence similarity, tokenizer support, and more. On to other news of the month. First of all, .NET Interactive Notebooks has been renamed to Polyglot Notebooks to better match the fact that it supports tons of languages. The Upgrade Assistant has support for migrating WCF apps using Core WCF. And the public preview of Dev Tunnels for Visual Studio for ASP.NET Core is out. That is super useful. So you can check that out. And GitHub Universe announced a lot of great stuff, including 60 hours of GitHub code spaces for free each month. In community, we had the release of .NET Community Toolkit 8.1.0 Preview 1. The C# Discord community ran their own conference, which is cool. All of the videos for that are up. And finally, there are lots of local events for you to check out. Those are running on the .NET Conf website through the end of January. That's all I got for you this month. See you next month.